Hey, what's up? Today I'm going to show you the exact Pinterest automation that took me from literally zero to over 130,000 monthly views. This isn't some vague strategy or theory. I'm going to show you the exact workflow I built that creates posts, Pinterest pins automatically while I was asleep. No more spending hours in Canva or manually scheduling out content. Before I built this system, I was spending about 5 hours on one pin. That's how efficient I am. But now I do it all automatically. Here's a look at my Pinterest analytics dashboard. We went from literally nothing to over 130,000 monthly views in just a few months. The best part, I literally don't even visit the app. The entire process from generating ideas to creating images to writing captions to posting happens all behind the scenes with this workflow that I built in make.com. Here's how this tutorial is going to work. First, I'll show you what exactly is this automation and how it works. Then I'll give you a walkthrough of it and everything that you need to set it up, including costs. I'm being 100% transparent. Finally, I'll give you a step-by-step walkthrough of building this in make.com. By the end of this video, you'll have a complete blueprint for building your own Pinterest automation machine that works for you 24/7 without you having to lift a finger. So let's dive right in. All right, so before building, let me show you exactly what this automation does. It's basically a content factory that runs on autopilot. The workflow starts by pulling ideas from a Google Sheet. We first have to create those ideas with ChatGPT or any other AI program that you use. These can be our blog posts, product pages, ideas that you want to promote on Pinterest. Then it uses ChatGPT, the caption, description, hashtags, based on your input. This is a completely hands-off. The AI writes everything for you. All you literally have to do is supply it with data in the Google Sheets. Next, it uses AI image generation, replicate, trend worthy of Pinterest. Again, no design skills needed. The AI creates the image based on your brand guidelines. Finally, it uploads it to Google Drive to make it life easier, and then posts the Pinterest pin automatically. It even logs everything back to your Google Sheet so you can track what's being posted. Let me show you a few examples of this pin system that is great for me. Look at this. They're all crafted for Pinterest. This is absolutely amazing. Absolutely what she wants, what's perfect for Pinterest, can bring you more brand awareness, which is what people need this day and age. They need more brand awareness. Now, before we jump into setting everything up, I want to be fully transparent with you. This is a powerful automation, but there are a few things that you'll need to make work and a couple of costs involved too. I don't want to sugarcoat it. I want you to know exactly what you're stepping into. First, you'll need a Pinterest API access. You'll need to apply for a Pinterest developer account and request API access. This process can take 1 to 3 business days to get approved, so be patient. Once approved, you'll need an API key. Then you can connect that to make.com. You do not have to pay for the Pinterest API key. Second, you'll need an OpenAI key for ChatGPT. This lets you generate Pinterest captions, descriptions, and hashtags automatically. You'll pay per usage, but it's a very useful and very affordable, and we're talking pennies per pin. Third, you'll need to set up a Replicate account. You have to sign in with GitHub and an API token. Replicate is a platform where we're going to be using to generate Pinterest images using the AI model provided here, the Audiogram AI Audiogram V2A. You'll need to grab your API token and connect it to make.com. Replicate charges per image generated, usually a few cents depending on what model you choose. I've generated a lot of images and I've only got to $2.92. You also need Google Drive and Google Sheets connected to make.com. This automation uses Google Sheets to store pin ideas and logs, and Google Drive to save the generated images. For cost, here's a breakdown. Replicate charges per image, OpenAI charges per prompt used, and make.com may require a paid plan if your operations exceed a free limit. One quick reality check, this automation is a bit complex. You'll probably encounter errors for the first time. There will be bugs, there will be frustrating moments, but that's normal. And with everything, the more you work with it, the better it'll get. And once it's running smoothly, you'll be able to create an entire month's worth of Pinterest content without ever even needing to touch Canva or Pinterest manually. All right, now let's start building. So it's going to look something like this. You'll need to go to Google Drive, or you have to create a Google Sheets. Your Google Sheets will look something like this by the time you're done with it. Basically, you'll need a lot of your brand guidelines, your website, where you're trying to direct people to. You'll need a lot of branding for what you're trying to create. right, I'm gonna do some prompt engineering real quick. Let's pretend I have a logging company and I am trying to ship people wood, but I need to advertise people on Pinterest about my logging company. I could say, what would be an example of brand guidelines for an Ironwood Timber Company Co. Have ChatGPT, or if you have these brand guidelines link around somewhere, they'll be useful to use in this scenario. From there, what would be a strategy guidelines for creating engaging Pinterest pins for Ironwood Timber Co. after it's given you or you gave it your brand guidelines? It'll create a strategy, and from there we'll work out even more. Then we want to say, create a month's worth of Pinterest pins for Ironwood Timber Co. or an example company that includes type, text on image, hook, design, title, and caption. Include the brand colors in the design. Do not include the logos or faces in the design. Keep the titles and captions short, concise, while promoting the brand and including a ZTA for our services, right? It's gonna work on all of that. And then we're gonna use that information to populate our Google Sheets. We're gonna take the type, text on image, hook, design, brand, title, caption, and paste that into the headers of our Google Sheet. We're going to copy in all of our data that ChatGPT has generated for us. We're going to click continue. It's going to continue generating. We want about 3 months of content because we could quickly go through a whole month of content in a day. Now that you got 3 months of content in your Google Sheet, we now want to go through and start pulling this information in. This Google Sheets module, we want to watch new roles. Click yes, our limit is one. You want to then connect the tools to set multiple variables. In the multiple variables module, we want to have the aspect ratio of 9:16. The API URL, which in this case is ideogram 2A. The API URL is this model right here. So if you go to ideogram-v2a in replicate.com, you'll be able to find this model. We're gonna take, this is an example HTTP request. We're gonna take this URL at the bottom and capture that and paste that in there. Then you then want to put your API key into here. The output format will be PNG. The magic prompt option will be on. The resolution will be none. The style type will be none. And the prompt will be the type, which is the type of Pinterest pin. Pinterest pin with design of include the design from Google Sheets. And it must have the words text on image hook. Then include your link so people know where to click on your Pinterest pin. This basically duplicates the HTTP request that is in here. And this is just an example. We're basically duplicating this request right here with the HTTP make a request right here. So we want to then put in our API URL. It's a post method. The headers will include an authorization, which includes your API token. And then we want to have another header that says prefer, and then the value will be weight. The body type will be raw. The content type will be application JSON. And the request content will look something like this, where you have bracket input, what is that, curly braces, and then all this stuff. It should look something like this, right? And if everything goes well, it should run great or halfway decent. So what are the errors? So it says fail to parse body as JSON and body character W. And that is probably because we forgot that our text on image hook cannot have double quotation marks, because if it does, then it's going to mess up the JSON object. We could fix that real fast by throwing that back into ChatGPT and then saying, replace the double quotation marks with single quotation marks. This is very crucial. Then it's gonna give us our table again, and then we can throw that back in there. After you've got the table updated with single quotation marks, we can now go back to make.com and then run it again and see what we get. And that is good news. It's gonna take a minute for it to complete because it's generating the image right now. So after it generates that, I'm gonna throw it into our other steps of that automation, which is we're gonna throw in a tool for sleep, and we're gonna sleep for 60 seconds. Then we are going to throw in another HTTP request to get the file with our authorization being our API token. And that's it. Our body type is raw. Our content type is JSON. And then we're gonna throw in another HTTP request with basically it's gonna have the same thing. It's gonna have the data, or it should have the data. And you'll have to run it from here just to populate that last HTTP module so that we can continue with the right endpoints. So that's gonna fail, that's okay. We need to populate it with more data. So in the get file, you want to have the output of the HTTP, the previous HTTP request. So after you got the get file module set up, you'll need the file name and to put into Google Sheets. And then you'll need the data, and then you could share it. You could have it anywhere you want in your Google Drive. And then we're gonna need the file ID into our download a file module for Google Drive. And so now for that, we could add a Pinterest module that will have, make sure to set up your Pinterest account on make.com. So the media source is gonna be a image 64 base, an image PNG. Google Drive is the file. This should pop up when you have everything linked correctly. And then our board, in this case, we're gonna be populating it to portal copy code. And then that does not have to be necessarily populated, but this does. And this will be our title and our caption. And then we want to include our link from this module here. And that should be it. You might have some problems with posting it to Pinterest all the way, but that's okay. And let's run it now. If everything went well, we should have everything go green, which is great. If you quickly wanted to debug what was going on, you could take this, you could double click this URL from the get file and paste it in and see what you got, and is logging bad for the environment, which is right on brand for our imaginary company, Ironwood Timber Co., which is great. It's right on brand for it. As we refresh this page, we could see our clearly defined work right here. Sustainable forestry explained is logging bad for the environment, right? And it includes the visit site, which we set as Google. So that's great. Everything works out great. If you found this helpful, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button for more automations like this one. I'm constantly building new systems to save time and scale my business and help others scale their businesses. I share everything here on this channel. I also have a WAP. I'm putting stuff on there too. Also, I've created a free template with all the Google prints, prompts, Google Sheet structure you'll need for this automation, so you can download it using the link below. If you have any questions about setting this guide up, drop them in the comments. I'll do my best to help you out. Again, this is a collective automation environment endeavor. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one where I'll show you how to set up and automate your Instagram content creation using a similar approach. See ya.